What do you think haggis would taste like? Alright, yeah, I'll just search that one, I guess.
The haggis. I think I can taste the sheep's stomach. I set my alarm for 6 p.m. instead of 6 a.m. And so now I'm like wet from sweating and the wind. I might die up here. That's okay. Biggest takeaway from being in Edinburgh so far? It smells like fucking fresh caramel corn here. I got off the bus and it smelled like I was at a fair. And it was like 11 p.m. Now I'm on top of a mountain and it smells like it. Yeah, I don't know if they're burning something, it smells like that. It's like walking through Harry Potter. It's like world of I guess Harry Potter's filmed in the UK. Yeah, fuck. One of my friends that came here told me it feels like a medieval town, and it's so true. Like, it just feels like a step back in time, and it's fucking so sick. Scotland's been the first place in a while, at least, that I traveled to where you walk by somebody, you can give them the stupid white person,
hello there,
like smirky nod thing, you know, and I'll say hi, which is kind of nice. In Poland, if I looked at somebody like that, they'd usually just glare at me, like they were confused as to why I was smiling. So a little culture change here. Still love Poland, of course. Okay, I don't know who decided to make these lion heads like the end of these stairwells, but. You know, nice little line with his tongue out, just eh, right? And there's this one. Fucking rail going into his mouth. So I like found online like this super famous like graveyard.
Ooh,
but so I'm walking through and I start reading some plaque. There's one talking about how J.K. Rowling actually found a lot of character names for Harry Potter in this graveyard, and notably Voldemort, like Tom Riddle. So I roll up, look around a little bit. It's like the only cleaned tombstone here, or gravestone, or whatever it's supposed to be called. Cool, find it, neat, right? Only clean one, whatever, I already said that. And then it says like the day he died is November 24th. Tom Riddle died on my birthday? So I might be the reincarnation of Voldemort, IRL. Creepy vibes here. I just found another one that a dude was born on my birthday in, again, old times. Like, I'm gonna stop at Voldemort's. But, like, that one, it's probably pretty rude to call the guy Voldemort. You've obviously had to stop at his, but weird that the random other one that I kind of stopped to take a read at as my birthday involved as well. Sketching me out a little bit. But to be fair, it was one of the cooler ones. It's got, like, a statue laying down with, like, a head. Of a head of a beheaded person? I don't know, alright. Like, there's a head, statue head also. His famous dog here, his name's Bobby, or was named Bobby, and he like allegedly sat, waited for his owner for like 15 years. I don't know if he was on his owner's grave or whatnot. But anyways, they have like a memorial for Bobby at this place. I saw there's a restaurant named after him as well. People like leave sticks by like the dog's memorial. People brought like logs and stuff. And they always clean the sticks away but as soon as they're gone, like, people start a new pile. It's kind of cute. Kind of, yeah, it's kind of cute. I love dogs. I saw that the National Museum of Scotland had free entry, so I was like, obviously debating going, because if it's free, why not? Until I saw this. I'm not exactly captivated by this, to be honest. Like, if this is your pitching point that you're advertising outside, it can't be that exhilarating of a place. But I mean, it is free, so we'll see. Maybe I'll get in there and have a really, really good time. Having a good time, having a good time. You shouldn't start leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car, passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, 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 there's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky. Call me a whale. I wonder if they're hiring. Yeah, let's get the haggis, neeps, and the tatties, and the Cullen steak.
Dude, no worries. Can I get you any salt and pepper or anything else?
I think I'm okay.
Oh, good.
Thank you.
So good and tasty.
Smells like a petting zoo. Not bad.
Oh, the aftertaste is like a weird lamb sausage, I guess.
But the aftertaste is kind of like a, I don't know if I'd order it if I was here all the time, but it's not bad.
So good.
It's called the Cullen skink. It's dead. It's like a fish stew, man. Yeah, it's really good. It's like a fish chowder. I recommend this. I guess try it because you have to. We're obligated. I'm wearing a kilt under the table, you know. No, the Cullen skink, I would eat this. I would definitely eat this. The more I eat the haggis, the less I like it. I have to finish it. I think I'm a coward if I don't. The soup is good. Am I gonna just taste it? I think I can taste the sheep's stomach. This is way too much food. I'm feeling weighed down right now. Oh my god. Okay, first off, fuck EasyJet. Second of all, it's like, it's 6:15 now. I woke up at 3:30. I'm spent. I got like, not enough sleep. Let's see why they call it a red eye, because, oh boy. So, I'm dipping out of Scotland now, and it was sick. Big takeaways. Cool medieval town in Edinburgh here. Second big takeaway, haggis, kinda. So that's it for Scotland. Tell me where else I should go, and what other questions I can answer for you, because checked off haggis, and it's meh, so...